Today we will make this Cajun spiced potatoes, which is a very tasty and yummy recipe of barbecue restaurant, basically barbecue nation. Guys, you will totally enjoy this at home. Making this is super easy, and the best part is the sauce that we will make with mayonnaise and the Cajun spices. So let's get cooking, guys. Welcome to CookingShooking. Let's begin the recipe, guys. First, we will prepare the potatoes. For that, here I am turning on the flame with the pressure cooker. In this, we will add the potatoes. Here I have baby potatoes, 20 of them. You can also do the recipe with about 4 or 5 regular potatoes. Add them in along with some water. After that, cover the pressure cooker and in high flame, we will cook this for 2 whistles. After that, you can lower the flame, simmer it for 1 or 2 minutes, and then this will be done. If you are using regular sized potatoes, then you can cook it for 4 whistles. After that, simmer for 5 minutes, then let it cool down completely. So after the pressure cooker naturally depressurizes, after that you can open it and then you can take out the potatoes. From here, the real recipe begins. Take a potato, after that you have to mash it down. But be careful, don't apply too much pressure, otherwise the potato won't retain its shape. So carefully just press them, and it's a very stress buster kind of a step. You will totally enjoy this. Just that it will take quite a while to shape them, I mean to flatten them, if you are making 20 of them like me. If you are using regular boiled potatoes, then you can just chop them into quarter size. After that you can mash it down like this and then you will be sorted. So here you can see I have pressed down or flattened all the 20 potatoes. They are looking great. Now we have to make them crunchy. Not every time the potatoes get crunchy, guys. So for making it crunchy, we will do a coating. For that, here I have a mixing bowl. I am taking 4 tablespoons of cornstarch and 2 tablespoons of Maida or plain flour. So basically 2:1 ratio we are using right now. You can take some water and then make a paste out of this. But this has to be on the thinner side. So add water little at a time, because there is too much of cornstarch, it will get slightly slimy. There you can see I have made a thin batter. It is actually thick, but because of cornstarch, it looks very thin. So slightly slimy and flowy kind of a batter it is. It is done. Now we have to take the potato one by one, dip it inside. After that you have to fry it immediately. Just one thing to be careful about is the thickness of the coating has to be on the thinner side. Otherwise, what will happen is it will not feel like potatoes. So here what I'm doing is I'm shallow frying the potatoes in medium flame. We will cook them until they are golden from the bottom side. After that, we will flip it. So you can place the potatoes one by one, cook it for 2 or 3 minutes. After that, you can flip them. Don't keep the flame too high, otherwise they will get soft very quickly. So in medium flame, I am cooking them. After they are golden from the bottom, just flip them around using tongs and then cook them until they are golden again. So in total, it should take 4 or 5 minutes and then this will be done. We have got such a nice amber golden color on these ones. They are looking great and the coating is also kind of invisible. These are done right now, guys, so I will take them out into a plate. No need to apply any tissue paper. These won't absorb a lot of oil anyways. Just take them out into a plate and then let them cool down for about 2 minutes. In that time, you can place the second batch of potatoes, and while they are cooking, we will make the Cajun mayonnaise. So for making the Cajun mayonnaise, we basically need the Cajun spice. I'm not using any packet spice powder right now. I will make it right now itself by using some ingredients. So first we will take the mayonnaise. Here I'm taking 3/4 cup of eggless mayonnaise. If you want to use homemade one, that can also be done. So just take the mayonnaise in a mixing bowl. First I added the 1/2 cup, after that the 1/4 cup again. So in total this is 3/4 cup of mayonnaise. Now, Cajun is basically super spicy, but not very much in barbecue nation. So what we are doing is we are adding the spices one by one. Here I'm taking 1 teaspoon of chili flakes, 1/2 teaspoon of mixed herbs. You can use any mixed herbs and that should be fine. I'm also taking 1 teaspoon of onion powder, 3 teaspoons of garlic powder. The garlic powder and onion powder is essential, guys. Try to use it and you'll get the best flavor. I'm also taking 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper, and we will take paprika in this. Here I'm taking 2 teaspoons of paprika. we might have to add more depending upon the color. Mainly the spice also, this has to be on the spicier side, guys. If you don't have paprika powder available, don't worry, you can use regular red chili powder also. But usually the paprika has a slightly sweet taste, so that should be helpful. We will just mix it up really well and then our Cajun mayonnaise will be done. The Cajun spiced mayonnaise is done, but it is very thick to be coated in the potatoes, guys, so we will have to adjust the consistency. For adjusting the consistency, here I am taking half the quantity of milk. So here I took 3/4 cup of mayonnaise. I am taking half the quantity of the milk. Just add it in and give it a mix. The consistency of this should be such that we can just coat the potatoes easily and it shouldn't be very thick. If needed, you can always add more milk, guys. This is done. You can see the texture looks amazing, but sometimes you might have to adjust the taste of the Cajun mayonnaise. We need it to be slightly sour also, so for that here I am taking about half a teaspoon of lemon juice. Just add it in. Be careful, don't be like Yaman, use a lemon squeezer so that you can avoid the seeds. But anyways, if you have added the seeds, you can easily remove them because of the consistency of the mayonnaise. So after removing the seeds, I am just going to give it a mix and this Cajun spiced mayonnaise will be done. Now my second batch of potatoes is also done, so everything is ready. Now all we have to do is serve them. So the recipe is very quick, you can see right now. For serving, here I have a plate. In this we will place the potatoes and on top of that just pour in the mayonnaise. Looks amazing. Top it up with some onions and coriander and a little bit of paprika powder and you will be done. This was our grill restaurant style recipe. While it is not unlimited at home, it is not small plate either. So you will definitely enjoy this. The best part is the texture of the potatoes and the sauce. So guys, that was my recipe for the crunchy potatoes coated in the Cajun mayonnaise. Try it out and share with me how it goes for you. If you liked it, give it a like button. If you disliked it for any reason, click the dislike button. I hope to see you soon with one more delicious recipe. Bye for now. Take care. Happy cooking.